WRRS.
WRRS, bring you the latest intermediate school news.
Hello, intermediate school, and I want to welcome you here to Channel WRRS on January 28th, 2022. I'm Brody Mullen. This station prides itself with bringing you the latest in intermediate school news. This week, we are highlighting our speech teachers that come to our building. They are Ms. Cross Gray, Ms. C. Oyer, and Ms. Samil. They help students with different kinds of speech and language needs and language development. Thank you for helping us. We want to wish them a fantastic year. We hope it goes swimmingly well. We have some fishing news now. This week, WRRS has picked the sea anemones because they look so special. We just have to know more about them.
The sea anemone gets its name after the anemone flower that looks similar to this creature.
Although sea anemones are mostly poisonous only to their prey, some species are known to be highly toxic to humans. Some are even potentially lethal to humans because of their toxins.
Anemones are similar to gold jellyfish and coral.
A sea anemone is made up of a petal foot, a body that is cylindrical in shape, and many tentacles that pull prey into its central mouth.
It only takes a very slight touch to trigger a reaction from the tentacles. Once touched, the tentacles shoot filaments into the prey that inject the toxin. This paralyzes the prey, and then the tentacles are able to guide the helpless prey into the sea anemone's waiting mouth.
It is estimated that there are more than 1,000 species of sea anemones found all over the world at varying depths in the oceans.
Some sea anemones have adapted to live in cold water, but most species prefer the warm tropical waters.
The largest of the sea anemones are found in more tropical coastal waters.
Sea anemones eat zooplankton, mussels, fish, shrimp, and other small crustaceans. Tiny marine larvae, worms, and any other meat they can find.
Some hermit crabs will attach sea anemones to their shells to provide them with camouflage.
Sea anemones are invertebrates and have no skeleton.
Some sea anemones live in harmony with green algae. The anemone provides the green algae with a safe place and exposure to light, while the algae provides food in the form of sugar and oxygen through photosynthesis for the anemone.
Sea anemones also live amongst clownfish, which have a mucus layer that protects them from the sting of the anemone. The clownfish live among the sea anemone's tentacles, and the sea anemone eats the scraps that the clownfish leave behind. The clownfish also help to clean the sea anemone's tentacles.
The sea anemone eats food and seed and sends waste out through the same opening.
There are over 1,000 different colorful species of sea anemones, located in deep and shallow waters all around the world. Sea anemones may look like plants, but they are actually soft-bodied animals. Anemones vary in size from less than an inch to over 2 feet long. They may have anywhere from a few dozen to a few hundred tentacles.
I hope that everyone is earning sand dollars for respect, responsibility, and safety, and keeping those dollars safe for when you can go spend them at a school store. We need to go to Miss Van Norman's class and find out what staff member won the Brandy Cup of Joe certificate this month.
The winner is Mrs. Thompson.
Congratulations.
It's time for...
This is Jordan Hill. This is school news.
Wyatt Hurd and Miss Van Orman's class has worked very hard and read his first book, Sam's Stickers by Madeline Heider. Check out Wyatt reading a few pages.
Stickers of myself. I like to book stickers of feet.
Good job, Wyatt.
Wow.
Great job, Wyatt. We are all proud of you. Look at what the second, third, and fourth graders have been doing with a green screen computer. They have been swimming in the ocean, being weather forecasters, and even riding on a roller coaster. Check it out. Check in with the library.
Good morning, intermediate school students. It's that time of the month again. We are here with our book box drawing.
So we're gonna draw our orange tickets for second grade. And the winner is
Sean Golens.
Sean Golens. All right, next. We will have our third grade. I'm going to mix it up for you, Mrs. Pretto.
Wow, it seems like there's a lot of book box tickets this time. It also seems like everyone's remembering their first and last name. Here we go. Oh, I spoke too soon. Aria, honey, you need your last name. Here we go. Our third grade winner is Zoe Leader.
Congratulations, Zoe. Okay. Number
fourth grade.
Yellow. They have a ton.
Wow. Our fourth graders are readers.
That's amazing. All right. Here we go. fourth grade. Oh.
Oh, we spoke too soon.
Call me a first name there. Sophia Odell. Congratulations, Sophia.
Congratulations. Now we're moving on to our fifth grade.
Ooh, they're blue. There's not many blue ones here.
Our fifth graders have to get in and use our library.
Or remember to fill out your tickets.
Or remember to fill out your tickets. Okay, Mrs. Hahn, there you go.
Okay, blue for fifth grade. And the winner is, Mrs. Carter, do you mind if I'm drawing it?
Not at all.
Mariah Brown. Congratulations, Mariah. And sixth grade.
Okay, our purple tickets. Here we go. Are you ready, Mrs. Hahn? You keep drawing.
Okay. I'm gonna go really fast. Sixth grade, who's the winner gonna be? Isabella Prescott.
Congratulations, Isabella. Lots of great winners this month.
And
how about our teachers?
Staff.
Here we go.
Maybe the faculty and staff will get more tickets when they come down to get some books for the book challenge.
Perfect.
Mrs. Van Norman. Congratulations, Mrs. Van Norman. And those are our winners for January. Make sure you stop down to pick up your book box winnings. Have a great week.
Hi everyone, it's Mrs. Mack here for this week's Counselor Chat. January always makes me think of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. I don't know if you know about him, but he was a man who believed that all people should be treated with respect and be treated equally. He also was a man who had a lot of great quotes. So for today, I want to talk about one quote that I really like. It is, "The time is always right to do right." Again, the time is always right to do right. So do you make the right choices and do the right thing even when no one is watching? I hope so. So hopefully making sure that you are being Red Raider strong, being responsible, respectful, and safe. Bye for now.
Don't forget, starting February 1st, Miss Bowie's classes are in the pool. That means Mr. Hall and Mr. Wilkinson are in the gym. It is that time of the month. Yep, it's time for the PE video.
And now it's time for physical education.
going to end our episode with a moment of mindfulness with Ms. Freeman.
Hi, boys and girls, and welcome back to Mrs. Freeman's Moments of Mindfulness. Did you know that the month of February 14th, I believe, to be exact, will be 100 days in school? So in celebration of this, let's think of 100 things that you can be thankful for. At first, you might think that's a lot of things, but just keep it simple. Simple things like, I'm thankful that I can write, that I can hold a pencil. Okay, so make a list. Bring it down to me. I'd love to see it. I'll see you next time.
This brings an end to our broadcast today. Remember to treat others in the way you want to be treated. Do what you're supposed to do and keep yourself and others from harm. Okay, say it with me. We are respectful, we are responsible, we are safe. We are red, writers drawn.